Hello students, welcome back to the another video lecture of ADS subject. In this video lecture we are going to learn about our next sorting algorithm, which is heap sort algorithm. So heap sort is basically work in two manner. First one is it uses array, and another one is also uses tree. Okay, so let's discuss about it. So heap sort will use binary tree. As you all know, what is binary tree? You have already discussed in third semester data structure subject. Okay, so in it we will use our heap. So what is heap? So heap is a ordered binary tree. Second one we will use, that is a max heap. In max heap, our binary tree will have parent greater than child, so that will be known as a max heap. So these two terminology we will use into our this heap sort algorithm. Okay, so first of all we have to create a max heap from the our given heap. So for that our pseudocode is given in this slide. Okay, so let's understand this pseudocode by an example. If we have this type of example, means 4, 1, 3, 2, 16, 9, 10, 14, 8 and 7, then we have to create a binary tree or heap from the this array. Okay, so as you all know that binary tree will have minimum 0 child and maximum 2 child. So let's create a binary tree, or we can say a heap from the array. So this 4 will become our root. This 4 will become our root. Then this 1 will become our left child. Then 3 will become our right child. Then next number is 2. So 2 will be placed on the left of 2. 16 will be placed on the right of 1. Then 9 will be the left of 3. Then 10 will be the right of 3. Then 14 will be left of 2. 8 will be right of 2, and 7 will be left of 16. So in this you can clearly see that we have already placed all the elements from the array to the tree. You will go like in this manner. Okay, first 4, then 2 child, then we will put other child to the 1 and 3, then we will put another child to the 2 and 16. Okay, if any other child is there, then we will put it here, then here, then here, then here. So this process will be carried out. Okay, so this is the way to create a heap from the given array. So we have created a heap from the given array, but we have to create a max heap. So what is max heap? So in max heap, our child is less than from the parents, or we can say our parents will be the greater than the child. So here we have many values are there which are greater than the root, so we have to adjust them. So first of all, here you can say we can see that 16 is greater than 1, but it is a child of 1 and root is 1, so we have to replace it. Again we can see that 2 is also less than 8 and 14, but also that is a root of 14 and 8, so we have to replace our 14 with 2. So it will become this. Here on right side you can see that 10 and 9 are greater than 3, but 3 is our root, so we have to replace them, and it will make this type of thing. Here you can see in this slide 1 is less than 14 and 16, so we have to replace 16 with the 1, and our thing will become this type of thing. Again you can see here that our 16 and 10 are 4 child. So 4 is less than 16. So we have to replace 16 with the 4. So our final maxim will be like this. In that, there will be root child or parent child's value. Sorry, root's value will be always greater than child's value. Okay, so this is our final heap. We will use this type of adjustment in our heap sort algorithm. Okay, so after we get our final heap, we have to proceed further. Okay, for making a heap sort algorithm, another term is very important, that is heapify. So heapify is similar to build max heap, but assume part of array is already sorted, that we will discuss into our next example. So for understanding the example of heap sort, let's take a array. Our array is 2, 8, 5, 3, 9 and 1. So for the applying our heap sort algorithm, we will follow some certain steps. First is create max heap, that we have already discussed. Second one is remove largest item. And third one is place item in sorted partition. Okay, so by following these three steps, we will get our sorted array as result. Okay, so let's start with the first step, which is create max heap. So in this example, our tree is 2, then 8, 5, then 3, 9 and 1. Means first element is 2, then other element is 8, next element is 5, next element is 3, 9 and 1. So this is a heap. From this heap, we have to create our max heap. So this is the max heap of our given array. In it, 9 will be the root, another values will be 8 and 5, and at the bottom our 3, 2 and 1. So by building max heap, we have to convert into again array. So our max heap's array is 9, 8, 5, 3, 2 and 1. Okay, so in this array, what we will have to do, we have to exchange, swap or interchange values of 9 and 1. Means we will interchange our first element with our last element. So after interchanging, our values is 1, 8, 5, 3, 2, 9, and also we have to replace that values into our tree also. So our final resultant tree will be like this. And after this sorting, this last element means 9 is sorted part of this array. And after that, we have to remove our 9 from our tree. So we have removed our 9 from this given tree. So our resultant or our these steps and tree is as given in this figure. So you can see here, this tree is not a max heap. Means in this tree, root node is less than child node. So we have to again do or again create a max heap. So that process will be known as heapify. We have to heapify our tree. So we have to change 1 with 8. After changing 1 with 8, here we can see that in this left side tree, our 1 is less than 3. So again, we have to heapify that. So our resultant tree will be like this, 8, 3, 5, 1 and 2. So again, we have to apply our first thing, which was we have to replace our 8 with the 2. So if we replace our 8 with the 2, so our resultant tree will become this type of. In that, 2 and 8 replace, so array will be 2, 3, 5, 1, 8 and 9. So after this step, 8 will be a permanent part of sorted list and it will be removed from the tree. So if 8 is removed from the tree, so you can see in this figure that in our resultant tree, 2 is a root node and its child is 3 and 5. Means root node's value is less than its child's value. So again, for it, we have to make a max heap. So we have to heapify it. For heapify, we will do replacement of 5 and 2 in this tree. And after that tree, it will look like this. In it, we will perform our replacement again. So in that replacement, we will replace our 5 with the 1, means our first value with the unsorted list last value. So if we replace 5 and 1, it will become this type of structure. In it, 1, 3 and 2 are part of unsorted list and 5, 8 and 9 are the part of sorted list. So after this step, we will have this type of tree structure. In it, 1 is root node and 3 and 2 are its child. So in that we can see 1 is less than 3 and 2, means root node's value is less than its child value. So again we have to apply heapify and we have to create a max heap from it. So we will, what do? We will replace 1 and 3 in this heap. So it will look like this. Root node is 3 and its child is 1 and 2. So in it, we have to replace our first value with the last value. So we will replace 3 with the 2. So after replacing it, our resultant array will be look like this. 2, 1, 3, 5, 8, 9. In this, 3, 5, 8, 9 are the part of sorted list and 2 and 1 are the part of unsorted list. So here again, you can see that our 2 and 1 are the part of our tree. So we have to heapify, but in heapify, you can see that here our roots node value is greater than our child node value. So if root node value is greater than child node value, then no replacement is needed. So after this, you can directly replace the first number and last number of unsorted array. So we will replace here 2 with the 1. After replacement, we will place 2 as the permanent part of its sorted list and we will remove this 2 from the our tree. So you can see here that in our tree, only one node is there, one root node is there, which is 1. So we can directly put this 1 into our array's sorted part. So this is a sorted list. So this is the process of sorting a array by the heap sort algorithm. So we have discussed that we have to create a max heap. We have to heapify, and after that we have to change first value with the last value of unsorted part, and after the changing value we have to remove the sorted value from our T, and this process we have to continue up to the our tree is become empty. So this is a heap sort algorithm. After it, this is a pseudo code of heap sort algorithm. So observe this heap pseudo code of heap sort algorithm. In next lecture, we will discuss about this pseudocode and program of this pseudocode, and what is the analysis of this heap sort algorithm. Analysis means complexity, best case complexity, worst case complexity, and average case complexity, that we will discuss into our next video lecture. If you like this video, then like, comment and subscribe my channel, and also share it with your friends. Thank you, friends.